Hello and welcome everyone. So in this video, let's talk about the for in loop and the for of loop on an array. We have already talked about how to create an array. Is just create a number array. Okay, so for in loop and for of loop are used for iterating or putting the iteration on an array, something like this. And here you can just do a console.log. Okay, so what it will give you, it will give you the values of I. So for of loop is a stop. We will take a look onto the for of loop in depth later. It actually iterate onto the iterable object which are generated using some generators, but array is also iterable object, so you can iterate onto that array using for of loop. And here I will represent the element, and this loop will run until and unless I becomes undefined. So the for of loop you can put on iterable objects like an array, so you will get all the values inside an array. Similarly, there is another thing is the for in loop. Here let's talk about that. So here for array 1, this is another array. Okay, and what I'm doing, I will be writing for in loop for it. So what it will do, it will also is it will be doing some kind of iteration. Let's see what output we will get. So for of loop is different from for in loop. So for in loop is actually to iterate the keys on an array or any object. So you see the values are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So those are not the values of an array. Those are actually the index. Now, let's try to do one thing here. Let's try to do console.log array 1. What you will get? You will get an array, right? So array is also the key value kind of thing, where the key is 0 and value is 3. So for in loop is actually used to iterate on to an object, and this index will represent a key. You see, I did a for in loop onto this array, and it is giving you all the index of that array. So array, if you see the array, array is an object, right? And in that object, what you are having onto the 0th index, the key is 0, value is 3. Key is 1, value is 3. Similarly, so for in loop is actually helping us to iterate onto the object. It can also be, object can be an array. In that case of an array, the keys will be the index of each and every element, right? So all these prototype methods are here. But for in loop is more useful whenever you are actually doing the iteration on a particular object instead of an array. How to create an object in the same way? And here you put some key value pair, where x is 60 and add another property, y is 80. Okay, here in this case you can iterate on to this particular object using for of loop. You just replace it with the object, you will get x and y. So what are the x and y? X and y are the keys. Okay, if you wanted to get the exact value, then what you can do, the object of I. So it will give you the value, right? So here object, you are trying to get the value from that object like an array, right? So object array is also being represented by an object, and object, the values from the object can be extracted like an array. So we have seen that console.log array. So it is actually the keys and values, right? And even in the object, like we are declaring some object, something like that. So if you do object, and here if you do zero object x, so what it will do, it is actually trying to get the value x 60, right? In this case, it's not an index, it's just a value placed at the index x, right? So this is actually representing the index. It can be anything. It is not necessary that it is going to be a number for us. So this is actually the variation between object and array. Here if you do the object y, you will get the next value. And if you try to print the value, it is not there. It's not there, right? So this is all about the for in and for off loop, which are the important aspect. And for in loop is usually used with the objects because we need to get the values and key value pairs in the object. So similarly, there are other methods like object.keys, object.values, and object.entries. We will talk about them in the later sections. But for in loop is mostly used for object, and for off loop you can use for any iterable objects like an array or collection of items.